guys coming back off of last week?
Really good. It was a little bit sluggish on Thursday. What you'd expect coming off a long way off in a disappointing game. But really picked up yesterday and today was our best practice of the three. So seems like we're back in good spirits right now.
So do we understand that Jalen Johnson won't play in the bowl game?
Correct. He's elected to enter the draft, which is no surprise. We all knew that was the plan from the original plan. And he's also decided that he's going to follow.
Do you stay out of that as far as the season?
I give my advice and my opinion, but it's ultimately the player's decision. And so I just give him, if asked for, my advice. So we did have a discussion.
So you have several guys who are projected as seniors who'd be, the NFL would be interested in, that could be drafted. You talked to some of them, all of them?
About that?
About that, yes.
About being drafted?
About playing in the bowl game.
No, I just figured I'd let us know if that's something they want to opt out of. And so far, Jalen's the one that has made that decision.
How about Brian Thompson's health for the bowl game?
We hope. We're optimistic, but he's not practicing yet, so we're up.
Is it a dead period for recruiting when you're down there in Texas?
Mm-hmm. It goes dead Sunday evening, and actually it goes to there's lots of different periods, but it's contact through Saturday, and then it goes to quiet on Sunday, then dead Monday and for the rest of the month. And in fact, for an entire month, the 15th of January, I believe, is when it cranks back.
Can kids come see you if they want?
No, not during that period. Dead period is dead. No contact on or off campus. You can still phone call one phone call.
So you can have exposure, but you can't do any recruiting when you're in Texas.
Exactly.
Do you have a lot of recruits who will be coming to the game? I mean, that's up to them.
Well, we have recruits in Texas, so hopefully those that can make it, and we understand that there's some that will be there.
Yeah. How would you describe how your recruiting in the state of Texas has evolved over the years?
Well, it's intensified, and Coach Mack, way back when, dabbled in Texas. We got a few players here and there. Brandon Warfield was a great player for us. Thomas Herrien, a few select others. We decided, I can't remember exactly what year it was, 06, 07, 08, somewhere in there, that we were going to make it more than just a satellite area. It was going to become a primary area, so we put Scally in there. He was 08, and he did a great job recruiting Houston, and then we ended up at this point in time in Texas. So it's one of our primary areas.
For a long time you went to Houston and Dallas, but you didn't go to San Antonio and Austin. Has that changed?
We just go, we've got the areas covered, but just the population bases in Houston and Dallas are greater, so there's more players there.
How many kids do you think you've signed in Wednesday?
From Texas or overall? Overall. We think all but maybe one or two of our scholarships will be filled up in the first round. It's taken a stair step each year. The first year we might have had half or 60%, last year maybe two-thirds, and this year's going to be more like 90%.
Because you had said early on you thought the early signing period would supersede the February one.
It has, and it is, and it's continuing to gain momentum. And I would say nationwide it would probably be about 90% as well. Just a guess.
When you recruit in Texas, what is the aura of UT?
It's obviously a brand, a brand name that a lot of kids in Texas grow up wanting to go to, but there's also A&M and TCU's made inroads. So it's not just UT, it's so plentiful. There's typically in a year there's over 400 Division I players in Texas, which is a lot of players, and so they can't all go to UT.
You have a good track record in bowl games in Texas and playing against Texas teams. How important is that aspect in recruiting kids from Texas?
Well, it helps. I mean, everything helps. Winning is the best. We played in there? Two or three?
Four.
Yeah. One on four?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's good. I didn't know that. I should have known that. But winning is conducive to players wanting to come to your program.
Kurt has dug up a stat that the team that has lost the Pac-12 title game has never won its bowl game. Is that something used to motivate guys that, hey, there's been a lot of letdowns, be the one who doesn't do that? I'm
sure he didn't make that up.
92% of all stats are made up on the spot.
That's interesting. Every for like the last 10 years, 8 years. Wow.
But to that, I mean, you were part of that last year, but right. Clearly by leading.
Should have won, though.
Right.
Halftime lead.
Yeah, exactly. So motivation.
Our own undoing.
Yeah, so clearly motivation was not a problem.
Right. We just turned the ball over 5 consecutive times or whatever it was in the second half. That's what has more to do with it, I think, than the previous game. That's an interesting tidbit.
For these bowl practices, what's the balance between player development and game prep?
It is about 60-40, game prep, 60% of it, and then we have 40% of it devoted to developmental work, and we have the travelers for a period of time, and then we cut them loose, and we stick have the developmental squad stay out and get another, you know, about another third of the practicing.
Is there anything about Texas that maybe lightens the game prep a little bit because of their talent or their scheme, offensively or defensively,
no.
Resembles somebody you've seen?
No. The process and the preparation is the same. You know, they're 11 personnel team, one back, one tight, throwing the ball well. They're balanced, but they appear to want to be more of a throwing team. But that doesn't play into our the process of getting ready.
Who do they resemble in the Pac-12, if anyone?
I'd have to think about that for a while.
When do the rules allow you to speak to grad transfers when they
commit to us?
When can you then?
Well, as soon as they're in the portal, we can talk to them. Are you talking about us announcing them?
Probably, yeah. You gotta wait till on campus?
Yeah, we gotta wait till they're just like a normal recruit. As soon as they've signed a paper or in a grad transfer situation, they don't sign national letters. They
right, so I was wondering, can you speak to a grad transfer on Wednesday?
Can I talk about them? You're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, I should be able to. Is that right, Paul? Straighten me out. As soon as we have the, once we've signed the scholarship papers, yes. Yeah.
Kyle, did you stay up on much waiver tape?
I sure did. Good for Jay Hill. What a great defensive effort. 5 turnovers and a block punt, so that's equivalent to 6 takeaways. And plan to win, play great defense, what he did. Did a nice job. We got to go to what, Old Dominion now? James Madison, I'm sorry. James Madison, yeah, so great job by Jay up there.